Welcome back to Innovation. I'm here with Patrick Lynch. Now, Patrick, farmers know you. Why?
I like to keep the pot stirred up. I like to be controversial. I like to challenge farmers. I'm never satisfied with whatever we got. And if we can't do something better, then we might as well get out, whether you're a farmer or you're somebody like myself. If we can't do something better next year than this year, you know, it's time to move on, let somebody else do it. and the farmers challenge me. And, you know, we get 200 bushels of corn and they'll say, that's good, Pat, but I want more. Or I get 5 tons of alfalfa, that's good, but I want more. Or I want lower costs, or I want my soil in better condition, or I want better weed control. And that's what we'll keep Ontario agriculture live, is this aggressive attitude of farmers of always wanting to do better.
And speaking of doing things right, we're here at the farm show and we're checking out a new technology, well, yep, sort of not new, and that's under the mysterious phrase deep ripping.
Yes.
What's that about?
Okay, deep ripping is not new. We had deep rippers probably 20 years ago where we would go in and loosen the soil down underneath. Back then we said we had a plow pan, and that was because the soil was compacted down to about the same depth as the plow was occurring. Mm. But indeed, you know, that was sort of coincidence. We have a compaction layer down underneath the frost layer. And as we've gone to bigger equipment, like we've gone to tractors that are 2-3 times the horsepower, the weight of the tractors 20 years ago. And that has compacted the ground underneath. 4-H farmers, they think, oh, well, I got alfalfa, I don't have any compaction. The 4-H fields are probably the most compacted fields. 2013, 2014, we had a wet harvest and we said, get the crop off, do whatever you do, but get it off, we'll fix the soil afterwards. And this year, the dry year, we are seeing some of the impacts of taking that crop off wet in 2013, 2014, really compacting that soil.
God, I mean, whatever happened to no-till?
Okay, so that's a good question, by the way. No-till, the idea is if there's no-till, there's no compaction. That's absolutely not true. There's enough studies, enough research to show that if you are no-tilling with big equipment, and many of the farmers are, you've got as much compaction as if you were doing conventional tillage. Now, this is, you know, a belief. I don't want to believe it. They always said it, I won't get compaction. If you do no-till with a 40 to 50 horsepower tractor, no, you're not going to have compaction. But if you do a conventional tillage with a 40 to 50 horsepower tractor like my dad did, we're not going to have compaction. But now with 200 and 300 horsepower tractors, with forage equipment, with big combines, I don't care if you're no-tilling, minimum till, conservation till, you're going to have compaction.
Now what happens if you don't deal with the compaction issue? What happens to your productivity?
It gradually goes down. So what we're doing with the subsoilers, the deep rippers, is going in and breaking that up.
Now by deep, how deep is deep?
Okay, so we want to go probably 12 to 24 inches. And how deep is going to depend on the soil and the farmers and where you found that compaction layer. So this is an individual decision. Now the soil here probably does not need to be deep ripped, but this is the soil we've got and we want to demonstrate the equipment, not necessarily the need to do it on this land.
So everybody that's in the business, there's some incredible names here, aren't there?
Yes.
I mean, yeah, so everybody's after that dollar, and certainly agriculture, you'd be the first one to admit, it's big business.
Oh, agriculture's big business. Here at the show, there's over $100 million worth of equipment. Now, I'm not talking about the stuff in the other displays. 750 exhibitors, and just in equipment, farm equipment, over $100 million on display. Yeah, agriculture's big business.
We'll be right back in 90 seconds. Stay tuned.
Mosquito control service from mosquito.buzz. We treat the areas where mosquitoes live, rest, and hide. Summer is short. Stay outside. Contact us today at www.mosquito.buzz.